Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. It's me, they call me Heat. You already know, we cooking up today, right? Yes, that's what we doing. So today I'm doing something totally different because I haven't had a turntable in a long time. And I finally got one, finally pulled it out. And you know, I've had vinyl over there sitting for so long. Future videos, you guys will be seeing me, you know, going to dig and grabbing these records up and creating from the actual vinyl instead of searching for, you know, samples on YouTube, which I'll still do because that's something that is still a part of digging. You know, you still have to search for the samples and things like that. But anyway, so yeah, that's what I'm doing today. I'm gonna be chopping up this record by Helen Reddy. The album is called No Way to Treat a Lady. So make sure y'all remember that. This is the cover here. And the song I'm gonna sample is called Don't Let It Mess Your Mind. I wonder how I'm gonna flip it. I don't know how. I don't have an idea just yet of how I'm gonna flip it. I already recorded into the computer the whole song. So yeah, I'm just gonna flip it and see what I can come up with, all right? So yeah, make sure you guys subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell button right after so you don't miss any more of these videos. Follow me on Instagram at They Call Me Heat. Follow me on Facebook, Producer Young Heat, or just facebook.com/theycallmeheat. Or you can follow me on Twitter at _theycallmeheat if you're on Twitter. So yeah, let's go ahead and get into the video. Let's get this sample chopped up. Let's cook up. All right, let's go. So I'm gonna go in and just grab the part of the sample that I wanted to use. I heard it at the beginning. Perfect chop, perfect loop. Turn the volume up just a little bit as well. Might have to try to grab other pieces of the sample too. Ooh, had to slow it down a little bit. All right, so I got this drum loop. I might swap out the snare, like lay the pattern down with the snare in it, but then take the snare out and throw my own snare in there. We'll just see what happens, because I like the drum loop, but I don't like the snare and the way that the snare actually sounds, so. Go find me some snares, a snare. So I grabbed the snare from like another drum loop and it actually worked perfect. I think I want to slow it down as well. I went to 175, I might go to 165. Yeah, I like 165 a lot better. Pretty dope. I'm gonna pitch it down on, try different pitches to see what it sounds like. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna drop a kick on top of the drum loop. I'm gonna drop a kick on top of that just to kind of beef it up a little bit. All right, so now I have this open hi-hat. You already know. It's kind of one of my favorite ones. I use this a lot, and I like this one. So I'm going to just tuck it in the mix. honestly didn't expect this beat to come out like this. It's crazy. It's nuts. I like this though. It's really dope. I like this. Figure out what bass to put in here. I don't even know what type of bass to. I'm gonna just do something regular degular, you know? Let's go to like grab contact or something. And so like, as you can see, like I just do the Scarby bass on there. I mean the Scarby bass from Contact on there. And then I threw a guitar rig on it to kind of give it a little extra, you know, flair. But this all came from the record. Started off with the record and then chopped it up in the Fruity Slicer. Threw a couple drum loops in the Fruity Slicer as well and went from there. So I'm going to test the bass out and see what I can come up with, all right? Alright y'all, as you saw, I just laid the bass line down. I really feel like this may be maybe the end of it. I'm gonna put some more little extra elements in it, but I don't wanna flood it with too much, you know what I mean? So maybe this is the end. I'll show you what it sounds like. This is what I did with the bass. Something simple, real simple. I didn't want to go too crazy with it. But when I dropped like everything in there though, when I put all the extra elements, like I had the kick, the snare, the open hat, you know, of course the sample and then the bass, when we throw it all together, it sounds like this. Something simple, all right? So I'm gonna just go in and kind of do some extra little elements or whatever, and then I think I'm gonna wrap it up from here, all right? Sample searching is like one of the hardest things. It's trying to find like the sounds that fit. Everybody, I'm pretty much done with this beat. I don't really feel like anything else can be added to it. It's like done. Really just need somebody to rap on it now, you know what I mean? So yeah, I think I'm done. I think I did really good. You know, I haven't done this in a while, as far as, you know, recording from a record and then throwing it in FL Studio and then, you know, chopping it up. I've always been grabbing them from YouTube, you know what I'm saying, and then doing it like that. So this is just it's not necessarily a new process for me, but it's something I haven't done in a while. So but anyway, I just want to thank you all for watching. I appreciate you guys. Make sure you guys subscribe, hit that bell button right after so you don't miss any more of these videos. All right? I appreciate all of you guys, and I'm out of here. Peace.